welcome to you guys. Today I'm going to discuss with you about the fleshy fruits. Okay, I'm going to explain each and every part of the flower as well as the fruits. Okay, let's see how these fleshy fruits are present. Okay. As a botanist, we all know the fruits which are formed after the maturation of the flowers. Okay? For others, fruits are nothing but to eat. But for a botanist only, no. The fruits are formed after the maturation of the ovary in the ovum. Okay? Now I am going to draw the parts of the fruit. Okay? Let's see the outermost layer of the fruit. Okay? Here you can observe the outermost layer of the fruit is the exocarp. Okay, the outermost layer of the fruit is termed as exocarp because it is outside. Okay, this is exocarp. Okay, even it is also termed as epicarp. Okay, it can also be termed as epicarp as it is outermost layer. Okay, below the exocarp, mesocarp is present. Okay, here you can observe. Mesocarp is present, but inside you can observe the hard seed. Okay, this is endocarp. Okay, endocarp. It is a little bit hard in nature because the seed is always having the hard nature. And above the endocarp and between the epicarp is mesocarp. Okay, it is mostly the mesocarp is mostly fleshy in nature. Okay, this is mesocarp. Okay. The fruit is composed of mainly three layers. The outermost layer is the epicarp and it is also termed as exocarp, and middle is the mesocarp and inner is the endocarp. These are the three layers which is formed by the maturation of the ovum. Okay? And these three terms are termed, means these three layers together termed as pericarp. Okay, these three layers together termed as pericarp. Okay, on the basis of the arrangement of pericarp, they have classified fleshy fruits into five types. Okay, on the basis of nature of these pericarp, the classification of the fleshy fruits are five types. I am going to explain you each and every classification of it. Okay, let's see the first one, that is. Okay, the first one is berries. Okay, let's discuss about berry. Okay, the berry is composed of bi or multicarpellary syncarpous gynoecium. Okay, the berry is composed of bi means two carpels. Okay, it has two carpels or many. Okay, it is having two or many carpels in which you can observe this kind of berries in fruits such as tomato, okay, tomato, as well as in guava, okay, and in berries also include grapes. Okay, in tomatoes, the outermost layer is the exocarp, in which the middle mesocarp and endocarp are fused together, and they constitute a pulpy seeds in which they are little bit hard. Okay, and in which the guava, you often eat guavas in which you feel many seeds inside your mouth. Okay, these are multicarpellary and the outer layer is very hard and the inner mesocarp and endocarp are fused together and they are forming the fleshy pulpy seeds inside the fruit. Okay, and we often see grapes. Okay, in grapes you find two seeds, isn't it? Whenever you eat a grape, you may feel two seeds, means it is bicarpellary, means the two carpels which are situated in this fruit, and that's why these constitute the berries. Okay, I hope you have understood. The berry is composed of bi or multicarpellary syncarpous gynoecium, in which these include tomatoes, guava and grapes. Okay, in grapes you have two seeds, that is bicarpellary, and in guavas you have multicarpellary in which many carpels are present, that's why we find many seeds in a guava, and they are very hard and they are skilled of clematis in nature. Okay, in vitamin C also very abundantly present in these guavas as well as in the Tomatoes, we can find the vitamin C, which are very abundant, and the seeds are pulpy in nature and they are very hard. The seeds are not easy to grow. Okay, this is about berries. Okay, I hope you have understood. Now let's discuss about the second part of this is drupe. Okay, drupe is very interesting to see. Okay, here you can observe drupe. Okay, as we all know, we often eat mangoes in the summer. Okay, the outermost layer of the fruit is fleshy and it is easy to eat, and we feel very happy after eating. But the endocarp, okay, here you can see the endocarp is very hard and they are mono, means unilocular. Okay, here you can see I am drawing a simple mango fruit. Okay, this is a mango fruit. Okay, in which it is having the outer thin exocarp. Okay, it is having the outer thin exocarp. Okay, and middle means inside you have unicarpellar, means only one, okay, only monocarpellary and endocarp. It is very hard and it is covered by a hard sheet like nature, and in between you have mesocarp. Okay, mesocarp, and it is very fleshy and it is edible. Okay, but in coconut the endocarp is very hard, and means the mesocarp is little bit fibrous, means they are used for the preparation of ropes. But in mango you can find the mesocarp is fleshy, but in coconuts the mesocarp is fibrous. Okay, this is the minor difference between the mesocarp in mango as well as in coconut. Okay, this is the drupe outer layer. Okay, the outer layer of the drupe is the exocarp. The exocarp is thin and they are light protective in nature, but the mesocarp is fleshy in mangoes and they are fibrous in coconut, whereas the endocarp is uni, means only monocarpellary, and they are hard in nature. Okay, this is the broad outline about the drupes. We can often find this type of drupes. Drupes includes mango, okay, as well as coconut. Okay, this is the drupe. Okay, now let's discuss about the Hesperidium. Okay, and one more thing I would like to say about in the drupe. In drupe, the ovary is superior. Okay, you can find the ovary which is superior in nature. Okay, but in other colors, in other fruits, it is different. Okay, in drupe, the ovary is superior and they are monocarpellar. Okay, now let's see about the Hesperidium. The Hesperidium includes citrus fruits. Okay, the Hesperidium includes citrus fruits. Okay, it includes citrus. We often cut lemons. Okay, when you get any headache or any illness, we often take lemons. Okay, if you cut a lemon, okay, the outermost layer is the exocarp, in which they are having a small eye leaves, isn't it? Whenever you cut a lemon, okay, let's see the diagram of it. Okay, here I am going to draw a simple diagram of a lemon, in this you have many locules. Okay, these are multilocular. Okay, and you have many seeds in it. Okay, these are multicarpellary and they are multilocular in nature. Okay, the outermost layer, here you can see the outermost layer is exocarp, and they are little bit hard and they secrete oil glands in it. Okay, the outermost layer is the exocarp, they secrete oils in it. Okay, and the middle mesocarp, okay, little bit paper in it. Okay, in the mesocarp, which is situated exactly outside of it, and they are paper in nature. Okay, whenever you take any citrus fruits, you often find below the exocarp the papery layer, that is the mesocarp. Okay, the endocarp is fleshy and they are multilocular and multicarpellar. Okay, the exocarp is papery, the endocarp is fleshy and pulpy. The endocarp is fleshy many herbs. Okay, they are drop-like structures and they are multicarpellary and there are many locules. You can find many locules. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there are about 6 locules in this. Okay, that's why it is termed as multilocular nature. In this, the ovary is superior in nature. Okay, in this Hesperidium, ovary is superior as well as in troops, the ovary is superior. Okay, this is the about the Hesperidium. Okay, after the Hesperidium, I am going to say about the pepper. Okay, now let's see the pepper. Everything is based on this outer layer and inner layer as well as the middle layer. Okay, on the basis of the nature of this only, the fleshy fruits are classified. Okay, now let's see the pepper. Pepper includes cucumbers. Okay, most of the cucurbitaceae families are included under the pepper, in which the exocarp is very, means they are hard and they are rind-like structures. Okay, the exocarp is here. Okay, I am going to draw a simple diagram of a cucumber. Okay, here the outer exocarp is rind-like, means they are very hard and it is resistant to any conditions. Okay, the outermost layer of the pepper is very hard in nature and they are very rind-like structures. Okay, and they protect the fruit from very harsh conditions. That is the nature and beauty of this cucumber. Okay, and the mesocarp. Okay, inside here you can observe the mesocarp is fleshy in nature. Okay, the mesocarp is, okay, it is fleshy. Okay, and the inner endocarp is having tricarpellary, means here you can observe, you can see tricarpels, means there are three carpels present in a fruit. Okay, in which the tricarpellary it resembles and they are very smooth. The endocarp is smooth in nature. Okay, the endocarp is very smooth and they are tricarpellary. That's why you are observing three seed heads in a one lock. Okay, these are tricarpellary and they are mostly unilocular in nature and they are having the smooth endoderm and fleshy exoderm, means the fleshy mesoderm is present and the outermost layer is the exocarp, which is composed of rind-like structure and they are very hard in nature. That's why we can survive several harsh conditions. Okay, this is the broad outline about the pepper, in which the ovary is inferior. Okay, the ovary is inferior, but in a droop as well as the Hesperidium, the ovary is superior. Okay, pepper, that is in the most of the cucurbitaceae family, they resemble the inferior ovary. Okay, this is about the pepper. Okay, next, last but not the least, that is the comb. Okay, let's discuss about the comb. Okay, comb includes apple. Okay, it includes apple, as we often get fooled by this apple. The apple is composed of inner true fruit and outer false fruit. Okay, the apple is composed of inner true fruit. Okay, I am going to draw a true fruit of an apple. Okay, this is the simple diagram of a true fruit of an apple. It is mostly bicarpellary, means they are bilocular or multilocular in nature. Okay, this is the true fruit of an apple. Okay, and the outermost layer, you may ask, what about this outermost layer? Actually, the outermost layer is the modified calamus, means the calamus which is growing harmlessly and it covers the true fruit and it becomes fleshy to eat. Okay, the fruit in the apple is actually the cartilaginous, and this is the true fruit. Okay, this is the true fruit, and it is mostly bilocular or multilocular in nature, and the outer layer, the outer fleshy layer is composed of thalamus. This is the modified means the covering of the thalamus. Okay, in which the ovary is inferior. Here the ovary is inferior. Okay, the inner cartilaginous is the true fruit and the outermost layer is the modified thalamus in which they are very tasty in nature. Okay, this is the broad outline about the fleshy fruit and the last one is the comb. Okay, you might know the word comb. I have made a small one to remember the scientific name of an apple. Okay, here comb includes apple. Okay, here you can see P and M. Okay, in M, Lusa means the scientific name of apple includes cumula, Malus cumula. Okay, to remember this name, you can remember this comb word. You can get the M denotes the malus and the P denotes the cumula. Okay, so this is the small trick to remember the scientific name of apple. I hope you have understood about the fleshy fruits. Thank you for watching.